Hey guys, it's Mike, and welcome back to part two of this video about property differences in Texas versus in Malaysia. So as you know, I'm back in Asia to surprise my mom for her birthday, and so I thought I'd get this opportunity to kind of do a video to show what are the differences. So let's get back into it. So in Asia, if you have a gas cooktop, it is most likely that it runs on a propane gas that comes in one of these, and it will be delivered to your house. You don't even have to leave the house to go get one. So this is how they get gas. They don't have a gas plumb from the provider like we do. So in Asia, all constructions are very much different from what we're used to in Texas. This is a wall, and it's actually concrete, not drywall. So you can't really drill, well you can, but you can't really run electrical once it is built. The only way you can add on is to run wires on the outside. And that is why they don't have a code like every couple of feet that they require a outlet, just like what we're used to. And not all walls have an outlet either. So extension cord is just a way of living here. So Malaysia is near the equator, so it's hot and humid. So most of the time you'll see standalone fans, ceiling fans, and most homes have a ductless system. And this is a unit for just the outside living areas. And each room has their own as well. Another fan mounted on the wall high up, and another ductless system. And most folks don't turn them on until it's time for bed. And then they'll set a timer for about 2 to 3 hours at most. Here's another feature that is different from what we're used to in Texas. Here's a light for the bathroom. And it's outside, not on the inside like we're used to. And here's the switch for water heater. So if I'm gonna take a shower and I want hot water, I gotta turn this on. And that is the water heater. So the house itself does not have a hot water that goes to the sink. So this is only in one direction, which is cold water. So there's no hot water here. There's no hot water in the kitchen. There's only hot water right there. And that's mainly for taking a shower. And also in the bathroom, if you notice, there's a drain. So you could technically, of course, you shower in there, there's a drain. But out here, you could actually wash the tile, or you can wash pretty much your feet out here with a water spigot. So that's one thing that we don't see in Texas as well. So here is another thing that is different from what we are used to. So these are outlets. Of course, you know, Asia and Europe and America uses different kinds. So you got an adapter here. But the other difference is that every power outlet has a switch. So this switch is off, this switch is on. For us, we just plug it into the wall and it'll start charging. But here in Asia, you would have to make sure that you plug it in and you press this button to turn it on. Otherwise, it doesn't do anything. Just like my charger has been sitting here for the last 3 hours and I forgot to turn it on. Most homes in Malaysia does not use a dryer, so it's essential that they have a space to dry the clothes. So you'll see hanging racks everywhere. This is how we will dry our clothes. Another feature of homes in Malaysia is that each home will have a water tank that acts as a reservoir. And this is typically about 250 liter or bigger, so 60 gallon or bigger. And this is for the use of the home. So even if they had no water from the city, they still have at least a couple of gallons to use while they wait for service to be restored. So what do you think about the videos? Put your comment on the bottom and tell me what are the features that you've seen that is weird, and what are the features that you've seen that make sense. and what are features that you wish we had in Texas. Thanks again for watching. This is Mike here with 316 Tim Realty.
Want more content like this? Don't forget to subscribe, comment, or like if you want to watch more videos like this. I'm Lorena.
I am Mike Yeo.
And we are 316 Team Realty.
Thanks for watching.